The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
Really good results coming back, some strong radioactivity right at surface. I think our peak was about 33,000 counts per second, which is really good. And then lots of favorable rock types.
Welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Sean Hillacre. He is the Vice President of Exploration for Standard Uranium. And Sean, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Likewise, Steve. Doing well, thanks.
So coming out with news about your Rocas project, and you've been completing some exploration on there. And we've talked about this in the past, and this is under an option agreement that you have with Collective Metals. So tell me a little bit about the work that was done and really what you're seeing, which is pretty positive.
Yes, absolutely. It's an interesting project. You know, we just talked about it in our last interview too, I believe, but just southwest of Key Lake Mine and Mill, right along the 914 highway there. So it's nice and accessible. It's about 4,000 hectares, and we got out there and got boots on the ground for the first time. So that was actually the first time that we had been down there on the project. So the goal of this program was to get out there, Steve, take a look at the rocks, confirm all of these historical uranium showings right at surface. There was, you know, almost 0.5% in outcrop there. So we went and checked that out and then explored all along the 7.5 kilometers of strike length there on the project. So really good results coming back, some strong radioactivity right at surface. I think our peak was about 33,000 counts per second, which is really good. And then lots of favorable rock types. So successful program. We took some samples and we'll get those to the lab and analyzed and kind of ground truth those numbers.
So in the news release, it talks about a diamond drill program in 2026, and this showed about a 7.5 kilometer strike length. So, Sean, I'm wondering how you sort of pinpoint areas that you would want to drill in without, you know, depending on how big the program is going to be. Are you looking at specifically where you get the most radioactivity or and then moving out from there? How does it work?
That's a great question. So we completed a ground gravity survey on the project as well last year. That kind of helps us identify areas along that strike length where there's potential alteration from those uranium fluids. So the conductors essentially provide the plumbing system for the uranium to be kind of focused on, and these, you know, hot, nasty hydrothermal fluids that carry the uranium, you know, destroy the rock around it and alter it, you know, often into clay, which is less dense than the surrounding rocks. So we get these anomalies or density anomalies. So that helps. And then we layer that with, you know, like you said, the radioactive showings, because obviously we know there's uranium fertility along this corridor, which is fantastic. And it's never been drilled ever. So we've got these geophysical layers that will layer up with the data that was just collected by our geologists in the field, and that makes for good drill targets. So this will be the very first time this has ever been drilled in history. So we're excited to get out there and start drilling. It's going to be funded and operated funded by our partners at Collective Metals, operated by us. And yeah, we're excited to get out there for the first time and test some of these targets for the first time. So looking probably about around 2,000 to 3,000 meters on the project.
Yeah, and really, Sean, another example of just how the company works, right? This just shows, you know, that the model that you have continues to show some success and bear fruit.
That's right, Steve. It's a really great way for us to, you know, move our projects forward, bring in other people, retain exploration upside, and, you know, keep all of our vendors busy, our geologists busy, and you know, it's a great way to make discoveries. You know, it gives us more shots on goal, as you might say. So we're looking forward to it, and lots of news flow to be coming out from all our JV projects and our flagship as well.
All right, look forward to that. Sean, thanks so much. Good to talk to you again.
Likewise, Steve. We'll talk soon.
All right, Sean Hillacre, Vice President of Exploration for Standard Uranium.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.